In 4 short years, Framework Computer has become the poster child of repairable laptop design with their highly modular laptops, and we're big fans of Framework after giving the Framework 13 a perfect 10 out of 10 for repairability. But we're not their only fans. Framework has built a dedicated following of consumers and businesses all around the world. Following the success of their 11th generation Intel series mainboards, Framework went on to show us exactly why we should stick with their sustainable design by releasing another 3 major upgrades in the years that followed. Framework's latest upgrade to their 13-inch line has now arrived, and it's the Intel Ultra mainboard, which, like the previous mainboards, is a drop-in replacement that's made simple through the use of strategically placed markers inside the laptop, on the mainboard, and QR codes with links to instructions. With that, I'm going to pull up the official Framework guides and begin the process of upgrading my mainboard to the new Intel Ultra Series 1. After that, I'll upgrade the webcam with a new 9.2 megapixel sensor and replace my LCD screen with a new 2.8K panel. Let's start by prepping my laptop for the upgrade. The very first thing I'll need to do is to remove all 4 of the expansion cards. One of the many things that makes this device easy to work on is the fact that all the screws are Torx 5, and all the screws holding the keyboard tray are all captive, so I don't need to worry about tracking where each one goes. Once all 5 screws are loose, I can flip over and open up the laptop to lift the keyboard up and disconnect it from the mainboard. The battery cable is easily accessible, though power to the system was cut the moment I removed the keyboard. I'm going to disconnect the speaker, audio board, display panel, and webcam cables, all of which are easy to get to. The wireless card is an upgradable and modular component in this laptop. Removing a single Torx 5 and bracket allows me to disconnect the cables and remove the card. I'll need to retrieve my RAM sticks for this upgrade. The Ultra Series 1 mainboards use DDR5 modules like the AMD Ryzen 7040 series that I have here. The SSD storage is up next, and much like the wireless card, it's held in by a single screw and comes away very easily. All that's left now is to remove the old mainboard. 5 Torx screws and no fuss, the mainboard comes out easy peasy. While I'm here, I'm going to prep the rest of the laptop for the screen and webcam upgrade. The screen replacement is one of my favorite things about the Framework. Banish all thoughts of glued-in bezels that break panels. All I need to do is tuck a fingernail underneath one corner and peel away the magnetic bezel. That's going to reveal 4 screws that release the panel from the rest of the laptop. It seems like no big deal, but the vast majority of laptops glue these panels and bezels in place, making removal and replacement a real pain. The webcam is also a glue-free component. Removing 2 Torx 5 screws and disconnecting a ribbon cable releases the entire assembly. Installing the new Intel Ultra Series 1 mainboard is essentially the reverse of removing the last board. The layout and design is so intuitive and streamlined that it took me less than 10 minutes to get to a functional machine again. Last but not least, let's add a touch of color to the setup with a few of the new expansion cards. Let's take a look at all the components we just saved by doing this simple upgrade. The aluminum frame, the keyboard and trackpad, the battery, though this is a consumable part anyway, the speakers and audio board, the wireless card, and the RAM and SSD cards. But even the old mainboard, if functional, can be resold on Framework's own website, which is one more component that can be saved from the e-waste pile. Compare this to the M1 and M2 MacBook Pros that we examined back in 2021. While the M-series MacBooks maintain the same logic board dimensions, the complexity of the board swap was only outdone by the numerous parts pairing issues we ran into after we booted the machine. And even where parts pairing wasn't at fault, like the trackpad, it's obvious that Apple isn't designing with sustainability in mind. So why hasn't anyone else done this? Well, Apple, Samsung, and the like have spent the last few decades trying to make the thinnest and slimmest devices we've ever seen, and their spectacular success has led to obscene amounts of e-waste. What's worse, companies like Apple and John Deere have successfully managed to monopolize the spare parts ecosystem for their products, creating a ripe environment for e-waste to flourish, all at the expense of the consumer. Framework Computer addresses this problem by rejecting the status quo. By creating laptops with individual components that are upgradable and backward and forward compatible, the Framework 13 lets you keep everything you like about your current rig while swapping out the parts that need a spec bump. This is the kind of thinking we need to achieve a circular economy, and we as consumers can promote companies like Framework to achieve this goal. So when you're due for an upgrade, spare a thought for the big picture, and maybe pick a laptop or a device that doesn't have an expiry date attached to it.